I almost should have waited for the fucking drop on that one. How y'all doing? How's everybody doing tonight? 7 seconds here. Well, that rate took a little bit longer. We ended up 2 weeks ago. We just sort of blazed through it, like way harder than we did the previous time. But like, I think our DPS was too good. We were actually putting ourselves in bad situations, basically. So like, we were dealing with the mechanic from like a previous phase while the boss is transitioning to the next phase, and like, unfortunately, that phase is such that if there's any other ads up, especially the ads that he likes to drop, they sort of fuck you, because you can't heal and you can't DPS until you do a specific thing that is hidden in a giant area of darkness. But either way, hope you guys are having a good day today. I want to continue Danganronpa 3 today. I thought about doing Persona, but I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to do Persona tomorrow, and I'm going to do Danganronpa 3 today, because I ended up having to cut the cast 2 hours early because I was falling asleep. I was exhausted. I think the entire weekend just caught up to me. But I got extra sleep last night. I've been good pretty much the entire day. I've been drinking shit tons of water. Not that it necessarily helps me stay awake, but it helps. It's doing stuff. So let's just jump into Danganronpa 3. All right? Because I definitely want to do more with this game, because I really enjoy this game. And again, I'll actually do the exact same thing I've done with I did yesterday. If you don't know what Danganronpa 3, or I should say, if you know what Danganronpa 3 is and you want to play it, and you don't want to be spoiled, feel free to come back later, check the VODs out. They'll be there available for you, either on Twitch or YouTube, wherever I end up putting them. But if you don't mind, go ahead and hang out. We'll enjoy some delicious Danganronpa-ing today. All right, so let's jump back in, because we hadn't even got that far yet. Oh, wait, did that not save my, where did I put that? Oops. I'll go ahead and put this up there on on my title officially, because hey, I want to be accommodating to Spike Chunsoft, who's at least letting me stream it without any problems. Hey Lily, how you doing? I'm doing pretty good. Like, my day's been pretty good. I'm feeling much better now, especially considering that I got some sleep last night. I'm about 2 hours in on chapter one, like barely, but then again, you might be further than me because I'm reading everything out loud, so I'm taking my time. I haven't officially met everybody yet. I got here. We were exploring this area, which also, it's all the stuff up here. Okay. Shot put ball for track and field. Does this place even have a sports stadium? That's kind of a good point. Hey, drones. I'm okay with the character voices. Funny enough, almost all of the character voices in this game did voices in Danganronpa 2. Almost all of them. Like, we've officially gotten, I think, almost everybody confirmed at this point. But like, almost everybody is either done character voices for Danganronpa 2 or Danganronpa 1. Kind of depends. And I can hear it, but they're also different enough voices that I'm like, okay, yeah, that is the, you're definitely doing something else. But so far, character voices have been fine. How about you? Are you actually running in Japanese, or are you running in English? I don't know if you've ever mentioned that or not. It's got a high jump pole for track and field. Didn't expect to see professional equipment in here. And then they got, I guess, the mats to land on. We have a lot of stuff in here. And I don't see anything else in the room. Wait. Whoa, what was that? Oh, I thought this was it. This was indicating on. I think I've already talked to you already, Mew.
What was that?
Leave me alone, I'm busy. Yeah, I thought so. Hey, Shuichi. Oh, that's right, she insulted his hat last time. Alright, let's go ahead and jump out of the room. I think we've done everything in there, we can keep exploring. Is that the store? Oh, can we gotcha? I guess it doesn't open yet. Aw, sad Christmas. I wanted a gotcha. We went in the dining hall. We already spoke to Rentaro. Wait. Can I even get through that? Oh, I guess I can. Okay. Sure. Who's over here? Nope yet. What is... Oh, that's just... That's my compass, not actually something in the hall. I was looking at the mini-map going, wait a minute, what is that? So, I almost feel like that's the... Like, half the idea for Monokuma is... His voice is supposed to be annoying. It's not supposed to be, like... Tolerable. Like, is that just a plain basketball court up here? Oh, I guess it's the gym. All the way to the gym. So the...
What's the matter,
Shuichi?
No.
Nothing, I just feel strange. How so? Like, okay. Deja vu? Like, I've been here before? Because that's the thing. Yeah.
Could it be
caught up in something even stranger than we imagined? It's natural to feel unsettled when we know so little about what's going on.
Yeah.
But we'll be fine. Probably. What makes you say that?
Because
we have 16 ultimate students on our side. As long as we work together as friends, nothing bad's gonna happen. Friends, huh? Alright, so I guess we go back? Did I miss a door again? Are you open now? Nope. Alright. Wait, why are there... It says ancient passport. Is there some kind of decoration? Oh, there's an indent in the middle. There's an indent in the middle. I wonder what that is. There's a lot of weird stuff here. Oh, I guess we're looking for something now then. Did that show up anywhere else? Both sides of this, I guess. I could swear I went in the dining. I'm almost certain I went in the dining hall, actually. Maybe there's like a section down here that I didn't go down. Wait, did I not? I don't think I went this way. Or did I? Can't get there. Wait, hang on. If that's the classroom. Wait, is this the same classroom? Now I'm actually lost. It's not the same classroom.
Hey!
Oh shit, this guy. Hey there, Agnola. This is Danganronpa. We are currently 16 ultimate students who are the best of the best in whatever they have to be. main character girl happens to be the ultimate pianist. And we're trapped in this school. And based on the way Danganronpa games go, we're gonna have to try to survive because we can't get out under normal circumstances. We have to kill somebody's gonna have to get killed before we can leave. So right now we're just in the prologue. We haven't even gotten to the good stuff yet. We're just sort of trying to find everybody. Like this guy.
Please stop.
Or that guy. Don't come any closer. The boy in white is chasing the other boy in the funny clothes. What happened here? Anything else in the room? Just... you okay, buddy?
Please stop.
Let me touch your body a little. I've always wanted to be friends with a robot.
Huh?
A robot?
What is it?
What? Are you another robophobe?
That's enough.
I have a recording function. If you make any aerobophobic remarks, I'll see you in court.
Hey.
Wait, you're a robot? You're for reals a robot?
No.
Are you one of the mono cubs?
Please stop.
Please, do not compare me to those toys. I am not just any old robot.
I am K1B0, the ultimate robot. But please, address me as Kiba.
Ultimate robot?
Hmm.
That's not fair. You can't be the only one who gets to show off. I'll introduce myself too.
Yeah.
Sure.
I'm Kokichi Oma, the ultimate supreme leader.
A robot and a supreme leader? None of this makes any sense.
By the way,
I learned the hard way that a robot's breath smells like gasoline.
How rude!
My breath does not smell like gasoline. I am powered by electricity, I will have you know. Just kidding.
That is not funny. Right?
Of course you don't think I'm funny. Robots can't understand human humor to begin with.
Do not mock me!
I have studied the complete history of stand-up comedy. I think you should have just watched stand-up comedy instead of studying it. Otherwise. Plus, I may have the appearance of a robot, but I am a high school student just like you.
Huh?
You're a high school student?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's Professor... Blah, blah, blah. I was created by Professor Inabashi, the leading authority in the field of robotics. He installed a strong AI in me, capable of learning and maturing like a human brain. That's why, at the time of my creation, I didn't know anything. I was like a baby.
But
the professor raised me like I was his own child. He taught me many things. Until finally enrolled me in high school.
How about this?
And now I stand before you all. See? I'm just like everybody else. Except we're not robots, but I'm just like everybody else.
Hey!
Wow! Whoa! Whoa! Kokichi here with the fucking hard-hitting questions. Do robots have dicks?
Hey!
Please don't ask such ridiculous questions. That's not answering the question, sir. I only ask because your backstory is pretty flaccid for a robot. Okay, this guy, he is... Oh, boy. The cast so far is going to be real strange. You see how being a robot might be enough to be called the ultimate robot? Hey, Kokichi, I don't really understand your ultimate supreme leader talent. Just the supreme leader of an evil organization. That's all.
Huh?
It's that simple. It's just that. It's all it is. Gotta say, it's pretty impressive. An organization has over 10,000 members.
Huh?
The supreme leader of an evil organization?
Because I'm a liar.
This guy, I swear to God. So wait, so you were lying just now?
It's true.
I am the leader of a supreme I am the supreme leader of an evil organization. That part's true.
Jeez.
Wait, so what were you lying about? I'm not telling you.
Hey!
What's the name of that organization?
Ah.
Oh, it's a secret. Because, you know, it's a secret organization. But I've never heard of such a large organization like that.
Maybe.
Where'd you have it? Because it's a secret.
Jeez.
Oh, I see how this loop's gonna work. Everything he said so far has sounded like a lie, so it's gotta be a lie too, right? Just leave him alone. Everything he's been saying has been a lie. He's far more suspicious than the person that I am. That's for sure. Well, of course you're not a suspicious person, because robots aren't people, silly. Wow. He is literally pulling the troll strings on this guy. Are you mad? You gonna hit me with a rocket punch? I've always wanted to be hit with a rocket punch. I gotta record that down. It's gotta be on a list somewhere.
You can't.
I don't have that function. Oh, man, you're boring. What a weird boy. He's like a mischievous little kid. This is no time to be joking around unless he really is a supreme leader. Give me that friendship fragment. Oh, I got two of them. I don't think there's anything else to talk to these guys about.
I'm disappointed.
Who creates a robot without a rocket punch? I mean, that's actually a really valid point. Why doesn't the robot have a rocket punch? If you're gonna make a robot and make it a humanoid robot, why not give it a robot punch? Like, why not? All right. It only seems like the best thing you could do.
Shuichi.
What should we do? You want to head down? The basement might be dangerous. This place is full of mysteries.
That's right.
All right, then let's proceed with caution. You go first.
Okay.
Okay. With hesitant Shuichi leading the way, we carefully made our way downstairs. Oh, I was gonna say, is it real super dark down here? Doesn't look very dangerous.
Really?
Some dangers are hidden where you can't see.
I see.
You have quite the imagination, don't you?
No.
No, I just don't think you're considering how dangerous this could be. Maybe we should look around the basement. There might be an exit. Oh, but we should be careful.
Okay.
Yeah. 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 The library? Who's in here? As soon as I opened the door, I gagged from the musty smell of old books. Is this a library? No, they just store books here.
You're right.
That book's all over the place. They just don't seem very organized. Oh wait, does that bother you? Are you a need freak, Shuichi?
No.
I was just wondering if someone was using it before us.
Huh?
No. It's nothing. Let's investigate for now. Well, that globe is clearly suspicious. What the hell is going on with this thing? Beautiful globe. Oh. Wow, that was... Wait, there's two exits out of this place? Interesting. That's kind of odd. There's also multiple bookshelves. We're going to go to the people last. There's a lot of books crammed in here, and they're all different languages, too. Oh, yeah. What was it? Hang on. Yeah. He did Ifumi's voice. It's great. How is anyone supposed to take a book off the shelf when they're crammed in like that? Well, that's what... Is it the same thing for all books, for all the shelves? This looks like a ladder for reaching high... Holy shit! Reaching books on higher shelves. Alright, same thing on this back one? Alright. Well... Let's at least talk to you. Wait, what? So that doesn't actually get her. That does.
Hey.
I actually think there's a bit of a different reason why they like Himiko. And I think an anime has to do with that. Because she seems very much like Megumin from Konosuba. Similar sort of design, almost. Are you an ultimate student, too?
Okay.
Yeah, that's right. Is that it? She doesn't talk much. I'm Kaede Akamatsu. I'm the ultimate pianist.
I'm
Shuichi Saihara. I'm the ultimate detective, I guess.
Jeez.
So that's, you know, not suppose. You are the ultimate detective.
Okay.
What about you?
Maki Harukawa, ultimate child caregiver.
Huh. All right. Ultimate child caregiver. Surprised? I don't look like someone who'd like kids, huh? Do I?
That's right.
You'd be right. I don't like kids that much. But wait, if you're the ultimate child caregiver, that means you must like children. Then children must like you a lot, right?
I don't care.
Kids are weird. They come to me on their own. I'm not that good at taking care of them. I'm not that friendly either.
Mm-hmm.
But they say kids are really intuitive. If they like you that much.
Hey.
And they can probably tell how loving you really are, Maki.
Mm-hmm.
Ah, that must be it. You've chosen the perfect career for yourself.
That's wrong.
It wasn't my choice to begin with.
Huh?
Wait, what?
So what?
Nothing. It's just, I grew up in an orphanage and got saddled with helping out a lot. Orphanage, huh? By the way, do you know anything about the Mono Cubs?
Yeah, that's right.
Someone's got to be controlling them, right? Any idea who it might be?
Like I'd know.
How would I know?
Hmm.
Fair point. Mono Cubs are definitely involved in our situation.
Uh-huh.
Hey, boy detective, shouldn't you have already figured out what's going on?
Huh?
He is a detective, but not a god. He can't know everything.
Yeah.
He only knows what he knows. I mean, who cares about some stuffed animals? Escaping this place is much more important. Wait, seriously? You think we can escape? Abducting ultimates from across the country would require massive resources and planning. What makes you think a group capable of that would just let us walk out the front door?
That's not true.
If they won't end this, then we will. I know we can do it if we work together.
What?
Work together with strangers? You're a naive fool if you think this can end so easily. Oh, okay. Okay, Maki. Yeah, I don't know that character directly because I haven't played Ultra Despair Girls. I'm pretty sure that's where that's from. I have it. I just haven't played Ultra Despair Girls. I might play it after this, but... After our conversation finished, she quickly headed out of the library. That was kind of odd. She didn't seem like the ultimate child caregiver.
Jeez.
Don't say that. Especially just not to her. All right. What is this? Is there like another section to this room or... It just dumps us out into a different area of the hallway. Wait. Okay, so that's... Wait, huh? What is this? Is this her... Okay, so that puts us there. And that's where that goes. That's not a room on my map. Let's save that for last. Oh, Chiaki would have loved this room.
Huh?
It's like a game room. This is a school, right? Is it normal for a school to have its own game room? It is kind of odd. Yeah, Shuichi was Leon. Wow. Nothing else in this room is really worth a damn. All right, let's talk to this guy.
What now?
What a strange place. I heard we were trapped here. I didn't expect to be in a game room. Are we really trapped in here? There's gotta be an exit, right?
You've still got a ways to go.
Is that what you guys are walking around looking for? You figure it out yourself.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
However.
Maybe trapped, but it's pretty cool here. We're to prison anyway.
Huh?
Prison? Wait, what? You're an ultimate student, aren't you?
That's an old story. Ryoma Hoshi, the man called the ultimate tennis pro. No longer exists. I'm nothing more than his empty shell.
Okay. Yamahoshi? Really? I've seen you in the newspaper. A tennis prodigy who single-handedly took down a mafia.
Huh?
You just done a mafia by yourself?
If I remember correctly.
Paper said he shot them through the head with his tennis skills with an iron ball. What the hell? Really? So you know that much already. Well, what do you think of the loser before you who used his talent to kill? But why'd you throw away your future like that?
Jeez.
Because I didn't need a future anymore.
Huh?
I mean, I can understand it. His voice, it is very similar to Gundam's. Gundam's is very sort of boisterous and like commanding almost. This guy's like, listen, bruh, I don't care anymore. Fuck the world. I'm already done. Very opposite end of like the personality spectrum for them.
No.
It's not like me to talk so much.
More importantly,
I'm warning you. Dangerous just to walk up to a killer like me. That said, he turned his back to us.
Alright, let's go at the sliding door back here.
Wait, it's locked? Why is it locked?
Yeah.
I don't know what's inside. Maybe we can come in later. Okay. Well, now I want to know what that room is that doesn't have a There's a door back here that doesn't have a room associated with it.
Huh?
What's wrong? This door barely opened a crack. Was it poorly built? There's nothing we can do about it. Let's search somewhere else. Well, okay then. Pretty sure that means I've gone everywhere down here. Okay. Wait, they opened the... Oh! Hey. Is this the entrance hall? Right? This has got to be the entrance hall, right?
Okay.
I guess.
Hey.
It means...
Mm-hmm.
The door must be the entrance. If we walk through, we could get out of here, right?
No.
Wait. I don't think we should open this door so carelessly. It could be a trap.
Do not worry.
This guy. Worrying about that isn't necessary. I've already examined the doors.
Yes.
You wonder, who is this? Shall make that clear first.
My name is Kurekyo Shinguchi. I am called the Ultimate Anthropologist.
I think this was Teru Teru. I think. Yeah, this was Teru Teru. You could hear it. I could definitely hear it in his voice. Kind of an improvement, I guess. Kurekyo anthropologist? Please call me Kyo. It's for anthropology. Would you like a simple explanation? Yeah, sure. Anthropology studies customs, legends, folktale songs, and much more. There may even be customs in your daily life which the origins of you do not even know yourself. For example, certain aspects of birthday or New Year celebrations. Anthropology sheds light on traditions and customs such as these through rigorous analysis. It's said that it's a study that examines the thought behind culture, faith, and customs.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I kind of get it. Not really, though. It sounds like a lot of fun, though.
That's correct.
Of course it's fun. It's a study focused on humanity.
Beautiful.
And there's that JoJo's pose. I can't believe human beings are creatures who possess infinite beauty. Yeah. I find all aspects of humanity, even the ugly parts, to be beautiful. Our present situation is rather intriguing. What beauty will I be able to witness here?
Beautiful.
People are wonderful. This guy looks like a creep, and turns out he kind of is one. Hmm. Anyway, can we go outside if we just go through these doors? Right?
If so...
You should find the answers to those such questions on your own. The moment your hopes are shattered, that too may be beautiful. Shattered? What does he mean by that? I was watching someone that was surprised with this voice actor and said, "Oh yeah, you got a good character, kind of like..." Yeah. Yeah, is anybody else in here? No, it's just y'all two? Alright. Mike.
Shuichi.
Let's go.
Okay.
Determined as I was, I couldn't muster the courage to take that first step forward. Yes, I was scared. Because what if beyond this is just...
That's wrong!
This isn't like me. Since I'm scared doesn't mean I'm gonna run away. I gotta move forward.
Are you okay?
Of course.
Hey. Don't worry about it. Let's go. I psyched myself up and with newfound strength walked boldly toward the door. Upon opening the doors, we were immediately greeted by blue skies, bright sunlight, gentle wind, and
a wall?
What? Both words were accurate. What stood before us was both a cage and a wall. Either way, the enormous wall struck a terrifying chord. The mere sight of its imposing presence was enough to send waves of panic through me. No matter where I looked, ahead, behind, above, or all around, the cage surrounded the entire school.
What is this? We're trapped?
What's going on?
Oh god, here they go. Oh boy.
Hey.
Surprised about the cage, huh? I totally understand how you feel. First time I saw it, my teeth and fingernails fell out. That's not a healthy way to react to anything.
Get a rock hard ranger!
But it's so awesomely huge. I can see why they call it the end wall.
Huh?
The end wall?
That's right.
Normally, walls are erected to separate two places, but that wall is different. It represents the end of the world.
Hey.
What are you talking about? What were we talking? What were we talking about? Was someone talking? Was I talking? That's just me. Was I talking? Because, I mean, I've done that before where, like, I'm talking, I don't realize I'm talking.
Geez.
Stop laughing and explain yourselves. There's nothing to explain. This is simply how it is. So please don't bother. You can't get out of here. That wall has no entrances or exits. Can't be climbed or demolished.
Well, actually...
Well, an ultimate could probably climb it part way, but most of the time that's impossible. What? It could still sort of climb it. Took a deep breath and shouted at the wall as loud as I could. Somebody help us! Please help us! Somebody! Anyone! Please help us! We're trapped inside this huge cage! I shouted as loud as I could, but for all my shouting, there was no response.
Stop it!
You'll hurt your throat!
That's right!
Scream all you like. No one can hear you in here, anyways. Wait, no one can hear us?
Hey!
What do you mean? What do you mean no one can hear us?
Wait!
Say something.
Hey!
One of you just answer.
Damn it!
Monodam's ignoring them entirely because he refuses to open his heart. You can thank my fearsome bullying for making that happen. Let's all get along now.
Dumbass!
We're the Mono Cubs. We need to be tough and whatnot. What was that? Things? This school? What is all of this?
So,
you bastards, I'll have to use your legs and hands and eyes to figure that out for yourself.
Actually,
the But please watch your step. The school is still under construction.
Huh?
Wait, under construction? That thing? It's true, some areas did seem as if they were under construction. They're still building some of the facilities here. Are they still in the middle of building the school?
No.
I don't think so. It seems like they're renovating the abandoned school. Either way, the construction will finish once we set the exiles on autopilot.
Huh?
Exiles?
Hell yeah!
Once part of a biker gang, the exiles now work construction to support their wives and kids. Wait, do robots really need that kind of a backstory? Oh, really? Okay, I'll keep an eye out for that. I don't know if they're... Are they in the prologue section, or is it like once you actually get into like a main chapter? Because like, legit, I'm asking. Is that something that is just in this chapter, or do I need to like not worry about it for a little bit? Steering wheels are leopard print. The dashboard's aligned with arcade prizes.
You stupid!
Seriously, guys, knock it off. Sound like those douchebags with back. They sound like douchebags with stories, with backstories like that.
So long, farewell.
Oh boy. Okay. I'll keep an eye out for him. Thanks for the heads up. Again, but more importantly, is what they said really true? We can't get out? We can't go over that wall? And no one's coming to rescue us?
Jeez.
If I give up now, then what? I slapped both my cheeks, and as my face grew warm, I could feel my determination returning.
Hey,
Shuichi, let's see if we can find a way out. Slapped him upside his head, just firm enough to get his attention, though.
Ow! You know?
I'm not good at motivating others, but we can't give up just because of a wall. We came in somewhere, so there's gotta be an exit.
Yeah, that's right.
We're gonna be able to escape now, but we'll do it eventually, somehow.
Yeah.
Everyone just has to cooperate if we want to all get out of here. It's too early to give up. Way too early. Alright. Let's figure out my boundaries here. Back here. Okay. Yeah, that's the thing that is a little weird. This big ass wall. I mean, I just don't get it.
Hey,
I don't have it now. If we can't escape, then
hey.
What are you complaining? Oh, excuse me. What are you complaining?
Huh? Listen up.
Quit complaining and grumbling. It'll turn into a habit.
Yeah.
Besides, this cage is nothing compared to the vastness of the universe. The universe?
Got it.
Oh, my bad. I haven't introduced myself.
I'm Kaito Momota, luminary of the stars. Even crying children adore the ultimate astronaut.
Are you talking about the card game itself? Or are you talking about like one of the video games?
How about it?
I'm an astronaut.
Isn't that cool?
And never been to space, so I don't know much about it.
Of course, not anyone can get up there. I may be an astronaut, but I'm actually still just in training.
You're a trainee. But I'm the first teenager to ever pass the exam. I mean, normally you need a college degree to even take the exam.
Huh?
Well, then how did you even end up taking it?
So,
I had a friend who was pretty crafty, so I had him forward some stuff for me. That's illegal.
Yeah,
I ended up getting caught. It was pretty deep. It was pretty deep shit. I have not touched the card game since high school. I want to say high school. I think. I can't remember any other time since then since I've touched the card game. I mean, well, I've watched people play, but the card game's way different compared to what it was before. The people up top decided they liked me and let me in anyways. Of course, I aced the exam. Reckless. Sometimes you gotta be a little reckless to make your dreams a reality. No way I can wait till after college. I want to go to space as fast as I can.
But
you have a lot of energy.
Got it.
And everyone told me it was impossible, but I never gave up. Not for a moment. Because limits don't exist unless you set them yourself.
Do it.
There are no walls you can't get over. The same goes for that
Could
one.
It be?
Do you have any ideas how to get over there?
Shut up!
That's not the problem. That is a the problem. This talk's a big game. Wait, is it actually just called Totally Awesome? The actual thing is called Totally Awesome. Like, what? Okay, then. I think I'm gonna go to the dormitory first. Assuming it lets me in. I can't imagine it wouldn't at this point. This building is round and has a lot of smaller rooms inside.
Very nice to see you again.
Oh, good God.
Very nice to see you again.
Hello, Bear.
We're intruding.
Sorry to intrude.
Please.
What is it this time? And what do you mean by intruding?
The hell you saying?
This is your home, you bastard. We finished setting up the showers. Now you can go pee.
Hey.
Why did they just use the toilets? Even for number two?
Ah.
Wait. Whoa. Hold on, bruh. Do you go number two in the shower? Ew.
So long, farewell.
All right. Okay, Mono Cubs. Yeah, I don't understand why the card had to go through a name change, but all right. What do you mean our home?
Could it be?
What do you mean for us to live here? See, there are 16 doors. Perhaps a room for each of us.
Stop it.
I don't plan on staying here long enough to need a room. I failed to see their objective. What do you mean?
Wow.
They're holding us for ransom. A large, fat facility such as this would be unnecessary. Furthermore, I gather they would rather care for us than hurt us. In light of this, I failed to see the true objectives of the culprits responsible for our kidnapping us. That's a good point.
I hear you thought of that.
Why do kidnappers go to all this trouble? 16 ultimate students have been gathered here, but why? What's the reason?
Excuse me.
Pardon me, I haven't yet introduced myself.
I am Kirumi Tojo, the ultimate maid.
Please let me know if you require my service.
Yeah, this one will fuck you. This one. This voice actor fucked my mind. I was like, wait, what?
I see.
Oh. Okay. I can accept that explanation. Wow. Ultimate Maid sounds like a really cool talent. Wait, I've heard of Kurumi Tojo.
If I remember correctly.
An ultimate with incredible intellect and strength, working as a private maid. I heard that her work is so perfect she could complete any request given to her. Wait, she's that impressive?
I do not agree.
Please, you are exaggerating. I will not complete any request that is asked of me. Once I received a request to annihilate a rival nation, but as it was impossible, I rejected it. But being requested to do that is kind of impressive on your own. Is she gonna... Oh my god, I hadn't even thought about this. Is she gonna be Terminator Maid? Oh.
That's true.
I also heard that she's been hired as a bodyguard for several foreign dignitaries.
I do not agree.
I've only been employed as a maid, not a bodyguard.
I see.
But you've been hired by so many important people. You're like a super maid.
Yeah.
If you're not, what do you intend to do now? That's a tough question. What should we do? What would you do, Kurumi? I hold no opinions or desires to speak of.
I am a maid, after all.
My only desire is to... What is this?
Mm-hmm.
So please, think about what you desire for yourself and what you desire for me. No matter the situation, no matter what happens, I am here to serve. Even in the situation, she's more concerned for others. She is the ultimate maid, though. I mean, so Lee, with cards like that, every once in a while, people they just decide, you know what, we need to change this card because circumstances have changed since we released it or something. Anybody else in here? Okay. Yeah, that mechanic's real weird. I wonder what's going on there. Is that a ninja statue? But why is it here? There's a lot of odd things here. Well, this guy looks scary. He's so big and muscular. Excuse me.
Thank you.
Huh?
Thank you?
Sorry.
Sorry for scaring. Gonta scary looking. Most people not want to talk to Gonta when meeting for the first time.
As Gonta gentleman.
Gonta to say thank you. Thank you for talking to Gonta. You're just being so polite. Alright, let's take a look at this thing. What does this card even look like? Alright, what does it do? Holy hot damn, that's a lot of text. Alright. Once per turn during standby, you can detach XYZ material from this card. Special summon a monster, a frog, from your deck. Once per turn, either during either player's turn, when your opponent activates a spell or trap card or a monster effect, you can send one aqua type monster from your hand face up. From your field to the graveyard, negate the activation. If you do so, destroy that card, and you can set it to your field. If this card is set to the graveyard, you can target one water monster in your graveyard and add it to your hand. Okay, so it's some weird ass cycling set thing. He looks scary, but he's not very scary at all. All right, Gonta needs to make introduction.
Gonta's name is Gonta Gokuhara. Gonta's talent is ultimate entomologist. Gonta want to become gentleman. Becoming true gentleman, Gonta's goal.
Okay.
I see.
Oh, Senor Gonta. That's a really cute name. Really? Dude, thank you. Actually pretty nice. Silly me for being so scared at first.
Maybe.
Gonta, scary looking, huh?
Sorry.
That's not what I meant.
No.
He's okay. Gonta used to it. Gonta called scary since he was kid. You were a kid, huh?
Oh, Gonta see.
Gonta bigger than other kids. Other kids scared of Gonta. So kid Gonta play alone. That's how Gonta come to like bugs. When Gonta really focus, it's easy to lose track. One day Gonta goes to forest and finds bugs. They end up lost.
I see.
It sounds rough, but were they able to find you right away? Yeah, it took 10 years.
Huh?
10 what? Years? But Gonta fine. New family take care of Gonta. Okay. Not people. The wolves.
Huh?
But
really nice. Because the forest family, Gonta learned to speak bug and animal.
Gonta.
As thanks, Gonta wanted to show forest family what great gentleman Gonta is. How is becoming a gentleman going to thank them for that? This place is strange, huh? I suppose it's understandable that there are no animals, but no insects at all? That's strange. Not even one bug. Wait, you like bugs too?
Amazing.
What is your favorite bug? What do you like about them? I wasn't saying that I like bugs or
anything.
Wait, then you hate bugs?
Huh?
Wait, what? No, no. You hate bugs?
That's not true.
You don't hate them. You love them, right, Shuichi?
Okay.
Of course I do. I love bugs.
Thank goodness.
Okay, that's good. No bad person like bugs. Jesus. God, it was still just as, like, unstable as he was in the demo. That was scary. I thought you were gonna die. Honestly, I can't stand bugs either. But it might be best to hide that. Alright, so that is everything. Except, wait, hang on, am I turning around again here? No. The thing with Yu-Gi-Oh! Is that you can make a really great deck, but you always have to look if one of the cards you bought is banned. Oh yeah, they do the ban list pretty often there. Huh.
Yaha!
How are you?
My name is Angie Yonaga. I'm the ultimate artist.
You're pretty cheerful. She's a bit too happy, considering the situation we're in. There's no reason to carry bad thoughts with you. You gotta live life. You gotta live every day like it's bright, cheerful, and fun.
Cause Atua says so. Huh?
Atua?
I.
It's the god of my island. Always speaking with me. He's always with me. I messed that last sentence up, but whatever.
She's certainly devout. She specializes in painting or sculpting.
I do both.
Painting and I sculpt sculptures.
But Atua's the one that makes, who makes the art. I merely offer my body as his vessel.
So divine! I see.
That's interesting. You know what? If you don't mind, could you show me some of your artwork?
Of course, of course.
In return, you'll have to make an offering. What kind of offering? Every Monday and Wednesday morning on my island, a truck comes to collect offerings. Sounds oddly familiar to putting the trash for pickup. Don't worry, don't worry. When I say offering, I just mean a pint or two of blood. Wait, you were going to draw a pint or two of blood for me?
Sorry.
Yeah, that kind of stuff always sucks when you're like, I've got a really snazzy deck and it's just like, oh, I can't use it competitive anymore because because some of the cards in it are banned. I've been an Emix All Pass. What about you? Huh? Me?
Yep.
Boy's blood is also an acceptable offering.
Come on, come on!
It won't hurt one bit. Wait. Don't run away! This girl's kind of weird. Wait.
Huh?
Is that the bell? Actually, you know what? Oh, Jesus, fuck. Ow. Ow. Ah, that hurt. That was not my intention. I am so sorry about that. Can we get something? You know what? This will be good for a break music. I need to go use the bathroom, so I'm going to take a quick break here. While I'm on that break, do whatever you need to do to keep enjoying the cast. I'll be back in a few minutes, and we'll find out what's up with that bell. Stick around.
Just lie in your mind, fell into rest, but lies to rain that. I will.
Hello, people. Thank you for taking me through that break. That one. It's another one of those ones that's just like, okay, I'm going to be sitting in the bathroom for a hot minute, so we'll take care of that. But yes, we're back. Thank you for taking me through that break. Let's get back into some Danganronpa 3. All right. What's that bell?
Ah.
Look, the monitor.
Thanks for bearing with us.
You bastards!
Kept you bastards waiting, huh?
All right.
Everyone, please make your way to the gym. The opening ceremony can finally begin. Finally finished your preparations.
Hey.
You do realize you just read your lines backwards, right?
So long, farewell.
I don't like the way that message made me feel.
Hey,
Jim, opening ceremony? What should we do? What do we do? We're gonna go, of course. Everyone else is probably doing the same thing.
You're right.
I'm a little worried about this, though. I'm a little worried. I am very worried. You read a Chinese manga? Yes. Okay, I have to look up the name of this, because I think... I want to say this was a manhwa? No, it's not. I think the second one is actually the Chinese version. Let me look at this. Let me see if I've actually read anything. I'm not noticing, like, just going down like a basic list of Chinese ones. I have not read any Chinese manga before. I know I've read Korean manga before. That's definitely something I've done, but I haven't read Chinese ones before. Wait, can we go down this? Oh, wait. I misunderstood this. What this was? Yeah. Like, man, with the W right there, that's the Korean version. The one with the U is actually the Chinese version. Huh. I don't think I've actually heard of that one before. Wait. Okay, no, that's just the thing up there. I was gonna say, if it's up there, I'm like, I found one. Alright. I don't think I can warp yet. I'm not even sure that I would want to warp. Let's take a look here. Kind of an odd stuff. We're sort of in the lead up to the stuff. The fights are all gonna be like debate based. You'll understand once I actually get to it. But the weird shit's about to start, because I think we're about out of the prologue. Oh, really?
Do you agree?
All 16 of us have gathered. It's pretty spectacular seeing all 16 of the Ultimates in this place gathered in one spot. I mean, that'd be so easy going for much longer. It's no use thinking about things in situations like this, so eventually, Tsumugi just stopped thinking. What's gonna happen to us? I bet it'll be a big pain. What are you looking at?
Miniko!
Can you... You could use amazing powers, right? Because you're a psychic and stuff?
It's magic.
It's... I'm not a psychic. I'm a mage. Wow. Okay. It's amazing. I definitely want to incorporate that into Neo Aikido. What sort of training do you go... Did you undergo to gain your awesome powers? Talking about it's too tiring. You're pretty lazy.
Please wait.
Pardon me, but we need to be on our guard. We do not know if and where if and when danger will strike.
Please don't.
Don't say that. I'm so scared. I don't know what to do.
It'll be okay.
There's no need to worry. A duo will protect us.
Thank goodness.
Oh, that's good. What is this?
Yeah, that's right. Fucking moron!
Is your brain full of weeds or something? I'll whack him out of that skull of yours.
Don't worry about it.
Eh, just leave it to me.
Leave it to me.
Those teddy bears show themselves again, or I'll kick their asses.
Don't wonder.
Do we actually have school regulations yet? No regulations yet.
What's wrong?
What's wrong is that I came back and hit a button when I didn't mean to. Oh, it's that button. Oh yeah, so hear a noise. It's gonna be like that for a little bit until some bad shit happens.
See?
You hear that? I think I hear it. It sounds like an engine from a robot anime. Oh boy.
Yoo-hoo! Rise and shine our sign!
What's about to happen?
Everyone!
Behind Gonta!
What?
The heck are those monsters?
Wow!
Of course he's gonna think these things are cool!
Hell yeah!
They're... Oh god. They're exiles! Highly mobile bipedal weapon platforms! They got lots of hometown pride too!
What are you saying?
I can't keep track of these backstories. Whatever they are, they better kill off the Uggos and save me for last.
Hey!
Hey, Himiko, run! Why are you concerned about me all
By
of a sudden?
Way.
Didn't someone say they would kick all their asses?
Oh.
What the hell? Nobody told me about these!
It's okay.
Everybody chill out. There's no need to panic. We're probably not in any danger. If they wanted to kill us, they would have done it by now. But that, Rentaro casually walked up to the exiles. So what do you want from us? Clearly you want something. That's what the guns are for, right? Let me guess. You're gonna force us to do something, and if we don't, we get hurt.
That means
you have our attention. What do you want?
And that's that.
Jesus, he stuck up and took charge all of a sudden. Holy shit. Well, aren't you a wise guy?
Hey!
I'll start us off. Listen up. Here's what we want you punk asses to do. Oh, my heart's going a billion miles an hour. I'm gonna say it. You ready? Hell yeah,
it's a killing game.
Oh my god, he spoke.
Huh?
Hey!
Monodam! How dare you upstage me?
Huh?
Wait, what did you say? If I heard him correctly.
It's a killing game.
He said it again. God damn it, Mono Dam. I'm gonna crush you with this here, Exal. Yeah. Come on, we don't have time to fight amongst ourselves.
Okay.
If you don't stop fighting, I'm gonna crush you with this here, Exal. You too?
Leave it to me.
If this is what it's come to, then I will crush the four of you with this, Exal.
What are you saying?
Why are you including me?
Oh, well.
It's more appropriate for us to be hostile to each other. What?
You wanna go, Jabroni?
Jabroni.
Who you calling Jabroni? Jabroni!
What'd you say, Jabroni?
What the fuck is even happening?
I'll throw down any time, Jabroni! Check yourself before you wreck yourself!
Oh my god.
Seriously? Are they gonna get it on right in front of us?
Don't worry. Altua is watching over us. In a situation like this, is he just going to watch?
Either way, it's too dangerous. We need to get out of here, or else...
Now, now, now!
What?
My cute little cubs. You gotta knock off this awful fighting.
Oh, that voice!
Father!
Is that you, Father?
Papa Kuma!
Daddy!
Where are you?
Huh?
Daddy? At that moment, the lights in the gymnasium suddenly shut off. Oh god, they gave him wings.
I am the god of this new world! And the headmaster of the Ultimate Academy! The one, the only, Monokuma! Nice to meet ya! Yay!
Daddy's here!
Hell yeah!
Another epic entrance from Papa Kuma.
How nice!
Daddy's so cool.
My little cubs.
You're so freaking cute. And the reason I can tolerate your tiresome antics is because you're all so cute.
You're so cute.
Even when the prologue is going way too long, I'll allow it because you guys are too cute.
Yeah.
In fact, the very first prologue ever was only short because you cutie patooties weren't there.
Pops!
Are you mad at us?
Don't be stupid!
Don't be an idiot. I would never get mad at my cute little cubs, even though you look really mad. Oh, damn, he's mad. Daddy's cool even when he's angry.
That's right.
Pops is from a planet of handsome bears. They get cooler as they get angrier.
It's getting interesting!
Yes, Agnola, this is... the weird shit kicking in. Super Monokuma, Super Monokuma 2, Super Monokuma 3, and finally Super Monokuma 4.
How many times do I gotta say it? I'm not mad! Ah! Father just transformed into a Super Monokuma God, Super Monokuma!
Okay.
You only see when the gods themselves do battle.
What is even
anyway.
Happening? Alright. Anyway, I'm really not mad. In fact, I gotta admit, I'm actually proud of you guys. You really stand out from the rest of the second generation failures in the world.
No way!
Isn't that a little harsh? I'm sure there are some second generation success stories.
Yeah, but...
can't think of any, though.
That's right, Papa Kuma! You know all kinds of useless crap!
Oh boy.
He gets all his alternate facts from the most trusted names in fake news!
Jesus Christ, really? Okay. I just love embracing my children. They're so cute, I can't help myself. Usually ratings will plummet when mascots appear in sequels too much. But in this case, ratings are through the roof. All thanks to the cute model cubs. What's going on? Another teddy bear appeared. But that is no ordinary teddy bear. I can see it. Despair and madness swirling around that cursed thing. Whoa. First off, I am no teddy bear. I am Monokuma. And show some respect. I am the headmaster of the Ultimate Academy for Gifted Juveniles. Master? It appears to be some sort of autonomous robot built with an AI. What do you mean?
Dun, dun, dun.
Yeah, but...
The exiles are different, though. They're a brainless bucket of bolts. They're mindless, pretty killing machines that can only be controlled by us.
Sheesh.
Autonomous robots piloting weapon platforms. This is certainly turning into quite the story.
Actually.
Maybe me, but I'm worried about this killing game thing that you actually mentioned earlier that we sort of dropped off and got sidetracked. What do you mean by that?
How?
What is so amusing?
Yeah.
It's just when I said it before, I just kind of phoned it in and now I feel awkward. I want you students with your ultimate level talents to participate in a killing game!
Huh?
Wait, a killing game? Us?
Please stop!
Why would we agree to participate in a killing game? Huh? You guys don't want to do it?
Gota never do that!
Of course not! Gentlemen not hurt people! But if you looked around the academy, you already know then, don't you? It's surrounded by a huge wall. You can't escape to the outside world. As long as we have the exiles, you can't defy us. In other words, I hold the power of life and death over each and every one of you.
Sure.
So, what do you say if we don't want to die?
You gotta be kidding me!
Why would our friends kill each other?
Oh?
Wait, who said you guys were friends?
No
Wasn't
way.
Me. You guys aren't friends at all. Your enemies out to kill each other.
Huh?
The enemies? Your enemies? I still have a lot to learn from Father about sarcasm. All this talking is bugging the shit out of me. I gotta beat up Mono Dam just to relieve the stress. I don't like that. I'm not good with violence or gore or sad situations. Daddy, instead of a killing game, can we just do a rock, paper, scissors tournament? It'll be the same thing.
You stupid.
Who wants to play a game where no one dies? And you do have a compassionate personality. It's so cute, you just barely stand it. Why? It's cute enough to eat. Cute enough that I want to eat it.
Hey.
Oh, Fanny, you might want to dial the cute shtick back a bit.
Hey.
Cooling with the stupid banter, I want to ask something. How are we supposed to kill each other? Are you going to give us weapons? What the hell, man? What are you asking?
What?
We need information from them. We can't do anything if we don't know anything.
No way.
Weapons? Huh? What kind of barbaric display are you envisioning? You couldn't be more wrong. Why, at the Juvenile Academy for Gifted Juveniles, or Ultimate Academy for Gifted Juveniles, a killing game is quite the refined, sophisticated experience.
What?
Huh?
Yeah.
Here, the killing game is punctuated by class trials. What?
Okie dokie.
Let us explain.
So if one of you maggots kills someone, you all gotta take part in a class trial.
The class trial is where the blackened killer faces off against their spotless classmates.
It's where you punk-ass bitches argue over who you fucking think the blackened is. After that, it's voting time! And if the majority of you idiots vote correctly...
Then only the blackened killer will receive punishment. So, girl, just imagining all the blood and gore makes me want to puke.
After the blackened is punished, the rest of yous will just keep right on living together.
But if you vote for the wrong person during the class trial, the blackened gets off scot-free, and all the spotless students get punished instead.
Hell yeah! Them's the rules of the class trial!
Woo-hoo-hoo! Ow!
Okay. That tongue is new. He's not had that tongue before. Explanation revealed way too much. You gotta be more coy, flirtatious, seductive. Just like your old man here.
Gross. Hey,
The point is, it's not enough to kill someone. You also have to survive the class trial.
How should I put this?
Kill without being caught, then survive the trial. Sounds eerily similar to the real world.
Unbelievable.
You think so? Then the outside world must be masterfully designed, even at its cruelest.
Listen.
One can likely imagine, but I shall ask just in case. What is the punishment you mentioned earlier?
Yeah.
Simply put, it's an execution.
Huh?
An execution? Oh, this scene.
If you do a crime, you get punished for it. That's like the most basic rule of society. But this is a killing game. So the punishment for murder is a bit more permanent.
Just a smidge.
Hell yeah!
I wonder what kind of punishments there'll be. Lots of blood and guts and brains, I bet. The kind of stuff that gives me a raging boner.
Yeah.
Did you already have a boner?
Get a rock hard
rager. Oh yeah, I'm so hard right now.
Oh, gory.
Blood, guts, brains. Is she vomiting rainbows? Like. No, that wouldn't be rainbows. It's not color the right way. Is that just like a solid, like, column of glitter?
Ah, man.
Oh, Mono Fanny just puked.
Get a rock hard rager!
I am literally so freaking hard. Puke gives you a boner too? You kid is just adorable.
What?
What the hell is cute about that?
Well, now.
All right, I'm over all this boring exposition. Let's get this heart-pounding killing school semester started already.
You have free reign to murder however you like, too. Like bludgeoning or stabbing. Feeling cheap? Try strangulation. Feeling lazy? Try poisoning. Whether you shoot, burn, drown, blow up, crash, electrocute, or laugh your victim to death, you can use any method you like to kill anybody you like, any way you like.
Oh boy.
At the Ultimate Academy for Gifted Juveniles, you will realize your murderous potential.
I don't even know, like, the Mono Cubs are weird. That's all I can really say to that. Change Monokuma's voice in this one. I swear Monokuma sounds a little differently. I guess, like, he has a slightly higher pitch to himself, which is interesting.
You got me.
Killing school semester. It's like a game. Risking our lives for some silly game is absurd.
But
seems like it'll be boring, though. How could you degenerates be so calm?
It can't be. It
has to be a lie, right? It's a lie, right? More like fiction. Like a story on TV. A scenario so removed from reality we can hardly believe it's happening.
It's no use.
I don't want to be the killing game. It's wrong. I never do that. Well, if you don't want to participate in the killing game, that's going to be a bit of a problem. Because the killing game is the only reason you're here.
Huh?
Now then.
Unleash your talents and have a happy, homicidal, horrific, hilarious killing game.
Oh,
wait just a minute.
Oh, stop it.
What you say, we won't do it.
That's wrong.
We'll never participate in the killing game.
I'll do it.
Whatever you have planned, I'm not going to let you get away with it. Heidi, you shouldn't just rashly defy that thing.
That's nice.
No, 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 no. I welcome her resistance. A defiant spirit is important to the killing game. It's fun to watch the defiant ones eventually snap and get their hands dirty. What do you mean by that?
I love it.
Everyone loves that kind of brutality in a death game, especially me. Wait, how big of an error are we talking about here? I don't think I've seen the translation error. If it's not too spoilery, you're welcome to drop it in chat, just as long as you make it known that's what you're linking. It never gets old. It's so fun, entertaining. I get just unbearably pumped up. As the new headmaster, it's my job to force you to do it. They're dumbfounded in silence, surrounded by the squealing laughter of Monokuma and his cubs. Think about the situation, he's so messed up. The academy surrounded by a giant wall, 16 ultimate students trapped inside, mysterious stuffed bears and deadly weapons. Yeah, I remember that during the opening sequence. What was bad about that? My new friends forced to play some killing game. I feel like something out of a sadistic work of fiction. Against my will, I was not a character in that story. See, now that image of her outside makes a lot more sense. We have a lot of stuff going on here today. What is that thing? Actually, you know what? Let's look. Okay, I'm actually gonna swap back over here. Because I could actually just pull up my VOD from yesterday. Just drag that window over here so I can access my VOD storage. Alright, so stream VODs. Let's get yesterday's. All right, so we have, okay, I'm gonna script the VOD real quick. Let's take a look here. Oh, wait. Wait, oh, mine didn't have it because I had already patched the game. Oh, wow. That's, I mean, I can understand that being a bad mistake because, like, that's really easy to go, oh, like, I could read over the Killing Game. What was the transition error was like? I could actually see my brain just like scrubbing over the Killing Game with Begin and not even thinking about it. Hey there, Edward. Or Edward. I actually have no idea what that character means.
What the hell?
How you doing? How you doing, buddy?
Can you get off my finger? Like, there we go.
That's. I mean, it probably came with a patch. It must have been pre-patched by the time I got it. I could have gotten a copy of it much earlier and downloaded it. Actually, no, I downloaded it before the weekend, so it's possible that, like, they had already fixed it by the time I got to it. After the Monokuma and the Monokubs left, an alarm suddenly rang for my monopad. Not just for mine, but the alarm was going off throughout the whole gym, which meant everyone had received the monopad as well. When I took mine out, the message displayed on the screen. Oh, okay. Students must live at the Ultimate Academy for the remainder of the foreseeable future. Once a murder takes place, all surviving students must participate in a class trial. If the Blackened is exposed during the class trial, they alone will be executed. If the Blackened is not exposed, all remaining students will be executed. If the Blackened survives the class trial, they will graduate and re-enter the outside world. The Killing Game and the class trials will continue until only two surviving students remain. Nighttime is from 10 p.m. to 8 a.m. The dining hall and gymnasium are off limits at night. Yeah, I noticed. Violence towards Monokuma, the headmaster of the Ultimate Academy, is strictly prohibited. Monokuma will never directly commit a murder. Your monopads are very important items. Please do not damage them. The body discovery announcement will play when three or more students have discovered a body. With minimum restrictions, you are free to explore the campus at your discretion. Students who violate these rules will be immediately exterminated by the Exiles. The headmaster may add new regulations to this list at any time.
You gotta be kidding me. I will never participate in a killing game.
All right, we in that daily life, boys. The Ultimate Academy for Gifted Juvenile School Regulations. So these are the rules.
Oh.
I don't understand why someone would force us to do this. But these rules are pretty cut and dry. This game doesn't seem like it'll be boring.
You gotta be kidding me!
That's not the problem.
Listen.
Please lower your voice. It's ruining the atmosphere.
Oh yeah!
Hey, what does that six regulation mean?
The killing game and class trials will continue until only two surviving students remain.
Yeah, that is definitely much harsher than it had been in the past. All right, what the hell is this? You can. Oh, huh. Huh, okay. Well, I know what that character means now. I don't know if I'll ever be able to recognize it off the top of my head, but okay. Only two. If the detective boy doesn't become a killer, he will most likely be one, or the Supreme Leader guy. I can see that.
Only two surviving students? What would be the reason for that?
That's.
Perhaps because you couldn't do a trial with just two people?
I see.
You're so smart, Shuichi.
Always messing around.
Quit screwing around. Killing games, school regulations.
Don't screw around.
To hell with all that crap. Who'd go along with something like that? Hey, don't raise the monopad. Is it to smash it on the ground? Hey, whoa, buddy. Don't do that. School rules say you can't break it. If you violate the rules, then the Exiles are going to dispose of you.
What?
I don't care about the rules. No way am I going to play at this messed up game. This isn't about playing the game. It's too dangerous to disobey him right now. Just forget about him. It just means one less dumbass for the world to deal with.
Shut up!
Hey, who you calling a dumbass? I took a deep breath and shouted with all my might.
Jeez.
Hey, quit fighting already.
Whoa.
What the?
Jeez.
We shouldn't be fighting amongst ourselves. Right now, we need to work together. Honestly, it'd be more inspiring if I played a song than give a speech. Mm-hmm. Chopin's military Polonaise would definitely help unite us.
Right.
I can get behind some Bologna. Bologna? Is that what? I don't even like meat or tomatoes. That's not Bologna. But Bolognese? I don't even like meat or tomatoes.
Right.
I agree with Kaede. We must remember who the real enemy is. Master told me that strength must always be aimed at the proper direction. I'm panicking too much. Just stay calm, like me.
Wah!
All right. Lee, you're gonna have a bunch of time to get ahead of me, because I will. I'm not gonna be playing it on Thursday. I'm gonna be playing Persona on Thursday, and then Saturday will be the next time I pick. Unless I don't have a Pathfinder game on Friday. If I don't have a Pathfinder game on Friday, I'll do a. I'm gonna probably be doing this alternating like every other day playing. I'm gonna go between Danganronpa and Persona. It's gonna take Danganronpa a lot longer to get through, but I don't want to stop playing Persona, and I'm sort of at a point in Persona where it's really easy to make progress. So we'll go with that. Shaking so much, can't even handle these intense vibrations. And trust me, I've got loads of experience. Okay.
Hey.
Man, why don't we just work together and search for an exit one more time? Look all over that wall. There isn't a single hole. I actually know of a hole.
Please wait.
There is no opening in the wall. Then how do we get inside these walls in the first place? That's a good point.
Got it?
There must be an opening somewhere. We just have to find it. Whoever trapped us in here wanted us to fight each other.
All right.
So let's show them we're not going to let that happen. We're not gonna fight each other. We're gonna work together, all right? Why are you guys quiet? Did I say something wrong?
I do not agree.
On the contrary, you made your case with such succinct aplomb? Aplomb. That word is
aplomb.
Oh fuck, that's really loud. I am so sorry about that.
Aplomb.
I'll remember that for the next time I do Google shit. I didn't think Google would blow it out, but okay. Okay. I was gonna say the same thing, but you beat me to it.
Got it.
You're exactly right. We can't give up so easily.
Come on.
Let's split up and try to find the exit.
Ooh.
Oh, Tua, give us strength.
Wow, impressive.
Missed. Admit, I admire your spirit.
Hey.
Wait. Yeah? What is it? We're just about to get started. Maybe it not matter much, but going to find manhole earlier in grass behind school building.
Huh?
Going to peek inside, see big underground passage. Think maybe it exit.
What?
Sorry, it's probably not so simple. You can't even mention important stuff like that much faster. God, I thought that scream was gonna end a lot earlier than it did. Going to peeking, see big underground passage. Think it may be exit.
No.
Wait, not like that. You're talking too fast.
Either way,
the boiler is behind the school building. We must corroborate Gonta's claim at once. Gonta, please lead the way. Okay, everyone, follow Gonta. With Gonta leading instead of the gym, we hurried. Just when I was about to follow after them.
Wow, impressive.
Okay, that was pretty cool back there. Huh? Wait, it How was? The way you changed the mood completely? Seems like everyone looks up to you. Looks up to me? Come on, that's ridiculous. I just spoke from the heart, that's all.
Sure.
So it comes naturally to you then, huh? That's even more cool.
You have what it takes to win.
Huh?
Oh no. Not this kind of guy again.
That means...
I'm just thinking... What you said back there would have pissed off whoever's running this. They definitely don't want us holding hands, working together.
Sure.
They're gonna come for you, Kaede. With everything they've got. I'm a little worried about you. So you're just so... straightforward. What the fuck? The fuck was that about? There he goes. I could stand to be a little bit less cryptic.
That's true.
Perhaps it's a warning. That's what I think anyway. Being strong-willed could get you into a lot of trouble around here.
Sorry.
I didn't mean to sound so negative at a time like this.
No.
It's fine. You only said that because you're worried, aren't you?
But...
Taro is a mystery. He forgot his ultimate talent as well. Is that something you could really forget? There's no use thinking about it now. Just head to the manhole. You're right. All right. I'm hoping that this place is open as we go past it. I do like that they made an effort to have the... Yeah, we're gonna go right past it. I do like that they made an effort to make the layout of the school is definitely different from the layout that I saw in the demo. I mean, there are similar assets and similar parts, but it is not the same. Are you open? I want to spread my murder creamer kerns. God damn it. I find it interesting that the actual doors are separated out from the main building. Wait, whoa. We're in chapter one, let's go explore. Fuck. How far can I go? Ooh. All right, so I need to be looking out for Monokumas. There are some. I would prefer to not miss any. I mean, it can't be helped if I do, but. Where everybody is. Well, this room looks wild.
Then,
looks like we're all here. So, where is this manhole? Over there in grass. Manhole in the grass. You poured a hole near some bush? Sounds familiar, am I right, ladies? Oh my god, there's like four of them that are like this. Holy shit.
Whoa.
Manhole cover looks heavy. Can we even lift it?
Leave it to me.
I could try. Kibo placed his hand on the manhole cover, and with all his strength, he...
My apologies.
Oh god, it's so embarrassing. Hell, he won't even budge.
Huh?
Robot's not even strong enough to move it?
Listen closely.
Don't worry, my physical strength is approximate to that of a strong senior citizen. Why would you build a robot like that? What? No! Have him have like a limiter that he has to like undo, and then he's like super robot strength. Have him be like a average adult human or something like that. That's fucking pathetic. Professor did not want a repeat of the tragedy that occurred during the trial production. Oh god, I don't want to know about that. I'm just really curious about what happened during the trial.
Allow Gota.
Allow Gota lift cover before to peek inside. Should be able to lift cover too. Gota place his hands on the manhole cover and...
Upsie daisy.
What the fuck? Bro, that's you are crazy strong.
So easily? The strength must be due to my magic. Yep, there's no mistaking it.
Oh, you're amazing, Himiko.
What should Gonta do with cover now?
Please leave it somewhere else. Be careful not to hit anyone with it.
Actually, Gonta no can do that. Very rude to litter.
But with nowhere to dispose of the manhole cover, Gonta begrudgingly tossed it aside. Manhole cover easily traveled 5 yards before it hit the ground. What wonderful strength. You could likely crush a child's skull with ease. Wow, that's kind of
Gonta
a really creepy...
Do that?
It's kind of a creepy thing to say already, but alright. Oh, gentlemanly! Gonta never do that. Gentlemanly, not... No one's going to do that. But Gonta's so much more reliable than some bean-counting robot that we all happen to know. Are you talking about me? Because I can count a lot of things, not just beans. Everyone was talking, I slowly peeked into the manhole. It's too dark to see clearly, but I could feel cold, moist air drifting up from it. This is kind of creepy. Are we really going in there? I'm sure it's fine. At least we definitely won't die down there.
I'll protect you.
If anything happens, I'll protect most of you. But the generous males are on their own.
Gonta protect you.
They're going to protect menfolk.
It's true.
It's awfully quiet down there. Where are Monokuma and the Monocubs?
I see, yes.
It certainly would show up at some point and crush us like rotten gnats. They probably haven't noticed yet. Let's hurry before they show up to mess with us. One by one, we each descended down to the manhole. Once we had all climbed down, we looked into around and saw an open area. What the fuck? It's more spacious than I thought it'd be.
What is
this place?
That is correct.
An old industrial passage, I suspect? Perhaps factories once existed here. That's all that's left of them?
Hey.
Take a look at this. What a considerate sign. Apparently the end of the tunnel is the exit. Don't you think it's weird that someone went out of the way to write exit? Don't piss yourself in fear. Your natural scent is bad enough. I'm not scared, and I smell just fine, I'll have you know.
Hey.
Well then, go on ahead. No point standing around here.
That's...
Yeah. Are we about to lose? What in the world is about to happen? It looks a bit dangerous, but we're all ultimates here.
Yeah, that's right.
As long as we were together, everything will work out.
Okay.
Well said.
That's exactly what I was going to say. We really are on the same way, Lake Kaede. Give me a hug. No.
Degenerate males.
Typical degenerate behavior. You were just trying to trick her into pressing her boobs against you. I mean, that is one of the side benefits of hugging women. So, sure. Let's go with yes. Oh no, we don't want to leave. Lots of poison barrels.
Hmm.
Is it worth talking? You seem to be rather introspective.
That is troubling.
I guess the other thing is, what are you looking at?
Be careful.
Hmm. All right. It'll probably be okay. There'll be an exit at the end of this, and once we reach it, it'll be all over. I just know it. I clung fiercely to that belief when we stepped in the tunnel. What? Excuse me?
You're about to take on the death road of despair. The objective is simple. Everyone works together to escape. Press the L and directional buttons to move. Press the circle button to jump. You'll encounter plenty of traps to set up to prevent you from escaping. If you hit a trap or fall off a ledge, that person will be eliminated, and control will switch to one of the remaining students. If everyone is eliminated, game over, man. Oh, sorry, I didn't mean for things to get that real. For now, stay vigilant and do your best to reach the exit.
What the fuck did... It's...
Not that it matters.
What the fuck? Oh,
everyone,
fuck.
Be careful.
Who's here?
Damn it.
Oh, I'm hitting the wrong button.
Leave it to me.
What the fuck? Are we literally gonna game over here?
Damn it!
Atua's on my side.
I shall go.
Bye, Onora.
So this
going
is
to
the
do
end.
His best.
I'm sorry. I couldn't do it. Make it.
Oh! What the fuck? Hey there, Lone Wolf. I don't know how to explain what I just went through, but how you doing, buddy? What? The slowly opened my eyes. It dawned on me that I had somehow lost consciousness.
Are you feeling all right?
You're awake? Are you alright? Fine, but what about everybody else? I looked around and saw everybody else sitting on the ground. Maybe what was it? Stunned silence. Sobering sadness filled the air. Oh, hi! Jeez, this is quite a pity party you sad sacks are throwing for yourselves. Oh, okay, so you're a little bit ahead of where I'm at. Alright. Alright. I just got into the first chapter, like very, very shortly. We'll see how much of it I get done tonight. I don't think I'm gonna be getting to it. I'm not gonna get through it tonight, but that's fine. I've heard that the end of the first chapter is really fucking wild. Like, I don't know what's gonna happen, but I've heard some shit. So.
Huh?
Monokuma, what are you doing here?
Rise and shine.
Oh god, the cubs are here too. You all look so exhausted. Poor things, I feel sorry for you.
Aww.
This place is filthy. It's murder on my cashmere skin. I bet Monodam is feeling lucky right now. His body's already a cheap piece of junk. Beep boop. Why don't you respond to it, Monodam? It'll liven things up a little, you know? So you guys crawled out of your holes. Guess you finally noticed what we were up to. Noticed? I know for a while you guys would botch whatever escape plan you had.
Huh?
I kind of also pretty much knew, too.
What are you saying?
That's a lie.
Then?
If you knew all along this was just a trap.
The
there was no exit. You tricked us.
Don't worry.
No, there's definitely an exit.
So?
I think you guys have managed to reach it if you all work together.
Yay!
There's nothing you 16 ultimates can't accomplish if you were together. Well, if at first you don't succeed.
Shing.
Try again. I'm okay with that. Like, just try as many times as you want it till you accept reality.
So long, yeah.
so we can escape if we work hard enough?
Fucking moron!
No way, you little moron. They'd be freaking out if we could actually reach it. Jeez. That's probably why they let us try. They wanted us to try the underground passage so we learned that escape is impossible.
You got me.
Instead of blocking off every exit completely, they leave just that little bit of hope. They want us to be desperate to go home. Corner us mentally.
Actually,
it's just rotten.
You might be right, but
we can't just give up.
Yeah.
I mean, we only failed once, you know? We can't give up this early, right?
Okay.
But isn't getting out of here possible?
That's not true.
No, it's not. It may take one more try or a lot more tries, but it's not impossible. Forget about Monokuma. He doesn't matter what he says to us.
I'll get us out of here.
I don't want to lose to him. And I don't want any of you to lose either. I refuse to lose to someone who would do these terrible things to us.
You're right.
Kaede. Mm-hmm. Let's all work together. Work hard to escape this place together. And once we get out of here, make it to the
what?
Outside world. Why don't we all stay friends?
Friends?
Yeah.
After going through experiences like this, I think we'd all be the best of friends.
Right?
I mean, it's not every day you get to meet other Ultimates. So what do you say? Yeah, it might not be bad.
Yeah.
That's a great idea. Yeah. And we've got all the more reason to escape this place, no matter what. My body is ready. You can tell by how much out of control my pit sweat is.
I'm glad.
So what you're telling me is that that's not the shadow underneath your arm. That's your pit sweat. Okay.
But
isn't it premature to say that we'll do what we'll do after we escape? Assumptions are all but useless.
Whoa.
Jeez, you're clueless. Oh my god, who the hell programmed you? Why am I not surprised that a robot can't read the air?
That's robophobic.
Robots can read the air. Thanks to innovations in pollen polluted detecting technology, Anyway, it doesn't matter if Monokuma says it's impossible. We'll show him what we can do.
You're right.
Seems like a pain, but I guess I'll try.
Yeah.
Let's work together. We messed up last time, but I'm sure it'll go well.
It'll be okay.
This will be fine. The divine wind will blow through and lift us to victory. Humanity is truly wonderful. The way you all covered it, confront adversity is beautiful. With our bond even stronger than ever, we stepped into the tunnel once more. All right. Oh fuck! I keep forgetting.
Everyone, be careful!
Here.
Damn it!
Atua's on my side.
I'll fucking do it.
Leave it to me. Damn it!
Yes, I'll go.
What is even happening?
I couldn't
Let's
do
go.
It.
What is even happening? Fuck
I'll
me.
Do it, huh?
Let's go.
Can you even make that jump?
Looks like
Let's it's have fun with alley-oop.
Leave it to me,
everyone.
I know scheduling.
Why is this jump such a bitch?
I am a failure.
Oh my god. Finally woke up, searing pain course throughout my entire body. I lost consciousness again.
Why?
What the? I was looking forward to a happy ending.
Don't worry.
Not yet. We're just getting started. Of course, this would be a piece of cake. Gonna escape. Become friends with everyone. Gentlemen, never give up. This time. I reached the exit. How many fucking times are you gonna? Those words carried me as I stepped into the tunnel once again. It was no good. Even so, we refused to surrender. We kept telling ourselves, this time we'll escape. But we failed each time. With every attempt, the words this time. We repeated the words this time over and over. But in the end, we couldn't do it. I thought we'd be able to escape as long as we never gave up. But it made no difference in the end. Failed.
Damn.
Again.
Seems like...
I can't go on.
That's wrong.
Wait, we can't give up. This time we'll...
Well, you know.
Knock it off already.
Huh? I don't like that.
You're free to keep trying on your own, but forcing us to join you is basically torture. Torture? You know what that really... You know what really hurts? Being denied the right to give up in an impossible situation. You won't let us give up, and no matter what we say, you have the moral high ground. Doesn't that sound like torture to you? When you say we can't give up, you're not inspiring us. You're strong-arming us.
That's wrong.
I didn't mean it like that.
Hey, degenerate male.
Quit being so selfish.
Please don't.
I'm not being selfish. The others feel the same way, too.
Huh? Everyone?
My spirit is nearly broken. This hardship gnaws at me.
Given the circumstance, the most logical course of action would be to give up.
Yeah, I feel like Hisashi Mitsui in the second half of a basketball game.
I knew this was impossible from the start.
This bullshit is a waste of my precious time and energy.
I can't let you all rely on my magic. Besides, I don't have enough MP left.
I'm just relieved that no one was seriously injured.
Praise be, Tua Tua!
Wait!
Please wait! We... No can give up?
Guys!
Are you really okay with not getting out of this place? We shouldn't have to push ourselves. Let's just find another way out, okay?
Huh?
What?
No way.
You're talking about the killing game, aren't you? Oh, so you're gonna interpret what I said like that, huh?
You gotta be kidding me!
What are you saying? There's no way we can do the killing game. Calm down. What's a bubble gum? You can blow pretty big bubbles with it.
Uh-huh.
Is it this little degenerate wants his head smashed into the ground?
Wait!
Guys, stop. We shouldn't be fighting.
Jeez.
We fell apart pretty quickly for a group that decided to be friends and work together.
Sorry.
This is my fault. I'm so sorry.
No,
Kaede.
Yes.
Idiot, what are you apologizing for? It's not your fault at all.
Mm.
Really? I actually think it's Kaede's fault.
What?
Why?
This is an announcement.
This is an official announcement from the Ultimate Academy for Gifted Juveniles.
It is now nighttime.
It's Betty Bat time!
Whether you've been good or naughty, it's time to tinkle and go Betty Bye.
Please be careful.
The dining hall and gym are locked during nighttime, so be careful.
Bedtimer sign!
Oh.
Nighttime, huh? Well, no sense pushing their luck. We should probably just get a fresh start tomorrow.
Huh?
Fresh start?
What do you think?
We've each been assigned a room in the dormitory. Perhaps we should just rest there. We're gonna rest there?
What's wrong?
My rooms aren't bad. Much better than my prison cell, that's for sure. But that makes me nervous to think we'll be staying the night at this creepy school.
Okay.
Nothing we could do but to suck it up. What's our plan for tomorrow? Since the dining hall opens at 8 a.m., how about we meet there at that time?
Right.
You know, I think that'll work. I'm okay with it.
It's decided.
Can we go to our rooms already?
Either way.
Yes, we should get as much rest as we can and regain our strength. I don't know if I can go pee by myself in the middle of the night. I'll come with you. If you don't mind, that is. Just let me know. Hey, guys, just as a warning. We shouldn't let our guard down. We'll be easy targets at night.
Please wait.
Oh, God. I'm hitting the wrong fucking button. Because of killing game, you mean. I see no need to worry about something as illogical as murder taking place here. I know, it's just a warning.
I mean...
Why did you apologize before? You didn't do anything wrong, you know. We tried to escape. I felt like we were united behind a common goal. But after I put everyone's lives at risk, that unity is gone.
Seriously?
Shut up. That's just the stupid end result. It's not like you wanted it to go that way. Listen up. Don't apologize for something that's not your fault. just make you feel bad.
You know,
everyone just decided to blame you and give up. I'm gonna give him a piece of my mind later. Well, anyways, let's just go to sleep for now. See you tomorrow. Thank you, Kaito. Kaede? I don't think you need to worry about what Kokichi said. You weren't pressuring us. At least, I don't think so. Thanks, Shuichi. I'm exhausted. Let's just go back to our rooms and rest. Right. Well, see you tomorrow. Sort of doing a quick scan. See if I spot any Monokuma Kumas. I don't see any. I also don't know how small they're going to be. Talk to Gota.
What's the matter?
You're not going back to the dorms? Going to worry about Manhole. Think okay with cover gone? What if someone fall in? Get hurt real bad?
Just go to gentlemen.
Gentlemen can no can ignore that. But Kirumi told Gota to leave cover off. Gota not know what to do. Everyone knows it's here, so I'm sure we'll all be careful. Don't worry about it.
You're right.
Oh, you're right. Maybe Gonta just keep eye on it. Thank you, Kaede. Gonta, go back to room now. Good night. Yeah. Bye. Gonta may look scary, but he's actually a very kind, innocent soul. Which one did we come in on? This was the side we hadn't gone yet. Alright, I'm okay with that. I am okay with that life of being team right instead of team left. Our team always go right instead of team always go left. This is also some weird music. Weird monument. Why is this here? Did you see that pool? They flipped the bitch. Pretty sure that was a pool. So, seems like we're missing some sort of key to get to that. Yes. Well, hello there, friend. How do I interact with something? There it is. Okay, well now I know what size I'm looking for. Holy shit, those are tiny. Like, holy shit snacks, those are tiny. Oh, we missed people because we went the other way. Alright, that's fine. I can loop back around and go back from the side that that we came in on the first time. I want to go the other way because I was like, I want to make sure that I'm not missing something on that side. And like I said, we saw there's a pool.
feeling all right?
Nothing the matter. Please rest and try to regain as much strength as you can. Escaping this place will prove quite difficult. Best not to fret over it. I mean, I understand that Monokuma was basically in the open and I just needed to view it from the front in order to snag it, but at the same time I'm like, how many of these are going to be super tricky? Because I can see them being really ugly spaces because they're there. This the school is really eerie. It's an interesting place during the day, but having to stay the night is too much.
With my magic.
If you really can't fall asleep, I'll put you to sleep with a magic hammer. That would be an eternal sleep. Oh, okay, Himiko. You do you. Alright, I figured as much. All right. Well, we found the one hidden Monokuma in the area that I've been able to spot. Maybe there'll be another one in a different area, but we'll have to deal with it at that point. All right. Let's go to our room. This is my room. Is that too shabby?
Huh?
Is this the key to the room?
Bingo!
You got it right. Nice work. That is, in fact, the key to this room. Probably don't have anything worth in stealing here, but you should still lock your door when you leave.
Hell yeah!
Now then, it's time for me to give you a special hint. If you steal someone else's key, you can sneak into their room and easily kill them.
That's wrong.
I don't want to hear that. I just got chewed out. This place is the worst. I just want to go home. Inside, there were uniforms that matched the one I was wearing. Lots of them. Did they prepare all of these? Oh yeah, that's one of the things I have to remember to do whenever I'm in a room like that is just slap them. Whoop-ha! Give them the palm. They prepared everything to keep us trapped here. Oh, right, that's the way out. I forgot. All right. So they want to do this, but I'm going to do it. Unlike what I was doing with Danganronpa 2, I don't think I'm going to need to do, like, a ton of multiple save files between each set. Just to make sure that, like, if I lose progress, I'm not having to redo a bunch of stuff. Because I can just... If I have to redo shit, it'll be stuff that... I'll get it done off stream. So that, ladies and gentlemen, is going to be it for tonight. I was actually like, is this song not going to kick in? What the fuck? I want to thank you guys for hanging out with me so much. You guys are all awesome. If you're new here, anyone to come hang out again, really easy. Hit the follow button up there in the upper right corner of your screen. I'll let you know when I go live. You can also follow me on Twitter. I always tweet out whenever I'm going live. So right now, the way I think schedule is going to work out is that Thursday, I think we're going to do more Persona. And then I'm going to do... I got to find out if I'm having Pathfinder this week or not. We'll see how that goes. If I am, I'm not going to worry about it. But if I'm not, I'll do a Danganronpa set on Friday, and then I'll do Persona on Saturday. If not, I'll do Persona on Saturday. I might even just do, like an afternoon Persona set, stop, eat dinner, do a Danganronpa set. Maybe. We'll see. I'm not sure how I want to do this, but I'll figure it out. All right, Lone Wolf Man. I'll see you next time, dude. Thank you for stopping in, buddy. That's everything, right? It should be everything. I think I'm probably going to do what I did with Persona, where I'm going to VOD these out on Twitch and not on YouTube just yet, even though I have the local recordings. I'm probably going to VOD them on Twitch first, and then it... Because Spike Chunsoft... I gotta go ask them what they want us to do about the VODs. Because I have it local recorded. I have it all local recorded, but having it archived on my channel is good for me because I want backups. Because, I mean, it's a single point of failure. If the drive over there fails, all those VODs that are on there are only uploaded somewhere else. So, hopefully that won't be a problem, but it's there. I'll have to ask through my contacts of NIS America for that. Because they could talk to Spike Chunsoft and be like, well, what do you want us to do about VODs? I'm hoping it's not delete the VODs, because that'll be really unfortunate. And what'll probably happen is I'll just make highlights and make VODs and make them private, so you guys can't see them, but they're just there for archive purposes. So hoping it won't be that, but we'll see. Otherwise, I'm going to get out of here. I'm going to go get wind down and get ready to go to bed tonight. But before I do, I need one kindness from each and every one of you guys. I want you to have a good morning, good afternoon, good evening, good night, good day, whatever happens to be, wherever you are at. And I will see you guys on Thursday for Persona 5. We have a dungeon to get to. I don't know how much of that dungeon we're going to need to get to, but we have a dungeon to get to. Right? Bye. We'll be right back.